Good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss Lecture 1, Chapter 3, Synthetic Fibers and Plastics. This is your subject science for Class 8. Topics to be discussed today will be fibers and fabrics, types of fibers, monomers, polymers, types of synthetic fibers, rayon, nylon, polyester. Now, what are fibers and fabrics? See, the clothes which are made up of fabrics, that like our bed sheets, our clothes, our daily wears, everything which we are wearing are made up of some kind of fabric. Okay, so these fabrics are obtained from fibers. Okay, it could be natural, it could be artificial. Like you can take example that when we go with natural fibers, they are cotton, and when we talk about artificial sources, like we go for nylon, rayon. So these are examples of natural and artificial sources. So we will read about it later on. Right now you can go with this. The clothes are made of fabrics. Fabrics are made from fibers obtained from natural or artificial sources. The type of fiber, as I told you, natural fiber. Natural fiber are obtained from natural sources. Like if we talk about cotton, cotton have a plant. Silk is observed from silkworm. The rearing of silkworm is known as sericulture also. Okay, wool is again coming from an animal. So all these things which are already existing in nature will be known as natural fibers. You can see here cotton, silk, wool. All these are natural fibers. Now coming to synthetic fiber. The man-made fibers produced from chemical substances. See, synthetic means artificial. So they are man-made. Man is making it. And these are produced from chemical substances, are called man-made or synthetic fiber. Example, rayon, which is also known as artificial silk and semi-synthetic fiber. Because in this fiber, wood pulp is also involved and chemicals are also involved. So this is semi-synthetic. And nylon was the first completely synthetic fiber. It is used in many purposes, in making parachutes, making car seat belts, etc. And acrylic is also known as artificial wool. It is used in making blankets, etc. Synthetic fibers are made from small unit of chemicals joined together in the form of large chain. So synthetic fiber is made up of small units of chemicals that are joined and forming a large chain, and that large chain is known as a polymer. Okay, so the small repeating unit of monomers, actually it's known as polymer. So you can see the definition of monomer. The small molecule that come together to form polymers are called monomers. Poly is a Greek word in which poly means many and mer means unit. So a polymer is made up of many repeating units. This is a diagram, or you can say a picture of polymer and monomer. Okay, these are monomer because they are single, and these are polymers because there are chain of monomer unit like this. Okay. Now polymers occur in nature also. Example, cotton is a polymer called cellulose. Cotton is having a polymer known as cellulose. Cellulose actually is made up of large number of glucose units. So you can see here, cellulose is made up of large number of glucose units. So cellulose is a natural polymer existing in nature because cotton is a natural fiber. Types of synthetic fiber. See, we have many types of synthetic fiber. Fiber is obtained by chemical treatment of wood pulp. The chemical wood is actually the natural part. Okay. But they are treating it chemically. So the chemical treatment of wood pulp, the fiber is called rayon or artificial silk. Okay. Rayon is also known as semi-synthetic fiber. Okay. This is because it is taking the wood also, and it is taking chemicals treatment also. Wood is a natural resource. Chemicals are not natural. They are inorganic. Okay. So because of this, wood
plus chemical, it is making semi-synthetic fiber. So it is semi-synthetic fiber, and it is, the name is rayon, and it is also known as artificial silk. It appears as silk, but it is not actual pure silk. It is an artificial silk, and it is cheaper also for sure. Rayon fiber can be made in different colors by dyed. You can dye rayon in different colors. We have many color of rayon. Okay, rayon is very cheap compared to silk. Silk is very expensive. For example, like if you will take an example of a silk sari, okay, usually the woman wear a silk sari. That silk sari, if you go for a pure silk sari to buy an emporium, it will cost you around more than 30,000 if it's a good quality of silk. But when you compare it with rayon, it is very cheap comparatively. Okay, so rayon is an artificial silk, it is not natural silk, and it is very cheap in comparison to the silk, pure silk. Rayon is mixed with cotton to make bed sheets, or mixed with wool to make carpets. See, rayon is mixed with the cotton. Okay, so we have rayon bed sheets also, okay, which we use in our day-to-day life, the bed covers, the bed sheets. Okay, and it is mixed with wool also. Wool also is getting mixed because they are a natural wool. The wool is all, again, a natural fiber. It is getting mixed with the rayon, and it is making carpets. Carpets which we use in our homes every day. Those are the carpets. So you can see this. This is a carpet which you use at your home. Okay, and this is the use of rayon fiber. And these are the clothes, the sari and the other part of the any kind of cloth which is used as artificial silk or rayon uses are here. Now coming to nylon. Okay, the name symbolized. Ny stands for New York, and lon stands for London. So actually, what happened? Nylon is the first man-made synthetic fiber. So it was completely synthetic. Means in rayon there was wood involved. But here there is nothing like any natural thing is not involved in this. So rayon was completely man-made. It was the first fully synthetic fiber. Okay. So, and how come this name nylon is coming? It is coming from New York. NY stands for New York, and LON stands for London. Because the process of production of nylon was started simultaneously in New York also and in London also. So you can read here. The production of nylon was started without using any natural raw material from plant or animal almost simultaneously, means together, in New York and London. Thus, it got its name NY for New York and LON for London as nylon. Okay. It is synthesized from coal, water and air. Clothes from nylon are very strong. See, we use parachutes and seat belts, all these, the car seat belts, these are made up of nylon. So obviously, if we are using parachute from nylon, okay, then means it is very strong, because why parachutes have been used for landing safely on land and for paragliding. So nylon is being used as a very strong fiber, and it is elastic also, little bit lustrous also, and it is easy to wash. Firstly, nylon was used in making bristle of toothbrush. Bristle means the upper part of the toothbrush which you use to clean your teeth. That is bristle. Okay. And commercially, after that, it is used for making fabrics. Okay. After that, it comes on the fabric. Before, it was using for making toothbrush. Nylon is used for making clothes, ropes, socks, curtains, sleeping bags, parachutes, etc. So these are the uses of nylon. The nylon fiber is stronger than a steel wire. As I told you, it is more strong than a steel wire. So these are the complete various articles made from nylon. As you can see, there are socks, there is a rope, there is a brush, there is a curtain, there is a parachute, a man doing mountain gliding, it's climbing the mountain. It is also done by the ropes of the nylon, and there are threads of the nylon here in the picture. So all these things are the example of nylon, how the articles are made from nylon. Now coming to polyester. As the name symbolizes, polyester means poly plus ester is made up of repeating unit of chemical called an ester. Okay, polyester is a man-made. Again, it is a synthetic fiber. It is man-made. Okay, fabric made from this fiber does not get wrinkled. See, polyester products does not get wrinkled. Okay, and you don't need to iron it, or you don't need to again and again. If you are keeping it, it will not keep, there will be no more wrinkles on that, and it will easily remain crispy, okay, because there will be no need of ironing that, okay, and it is very easy to wash because it will wash very quickly. Example: shirts, pants, jacket, bed sheets, curtains, sarees, mouse pad, etc. So all these are also made up of polyester. Okay, shirts, pants are available in different material also. Jacket are also available in different material, but they are available in polyester also. Okay, so polyester is used to make ropes, fabrics for conveyor belt. Okay, so what is conveyor belt? You must have seen this kind of belt in the in the stations, in the metro stations. So this in which we put our product and it go further, it is there in the airports also. So these are known as conveyor belts. In cushioning and insulating material in pillow, etc. Okay, so all these things, polyester is being used. Terricot is made by mixing two type of fibers, terrylene and cotton. So you can see this word, terry comes from terrylene, and cotton, cord comes from cotton. Similarly, there is polycord also, polywool also. They are also getting mixed with the other fabrics, and they are made up of polyester also. Poly, again polyester, cotton, poly, polyester, wool. Okay, and mixing fabrics are made by mixing of polyester with other natural fibers. Now, there is a word known as PET. PET is polyethylene tetraphthalate. It's a terephthalate is a very familiar form of polyester. Okay, this is a very familiar form of polyester. You must have observed that this PET is written in many of the water bottles, plastic water bottles which we use. Okay, so this PET is being used in making bottles, utensils, films, wires, and many other useful products. So this is being used in all these things also. Okay. Your homework will be that you will solve question number 1, 2, 3 in book and question number 4 in notebook. Okay, thank you.